Well, hi everyone. I'm just getting some compost together here because I'm going to plant some kale tonight. So I have a really nice late summer crop of greens. So I've got my compost, my kale, and my sand. All right, come on. Well, first let me show you where I'm going to plant my kale and why I'm going to plant it here. I have this bed here that I have some greens planted in, and you notice I have it shaded. Just have an old bed sheet clipped to this little fence I have here. And the reason I do that is because it's been super hot here this week, probably close to about 100 degrees, and lettuce and greens just doesn't hold up as well to the heat. So the shade really helps that, keeps the sun off it. But there's only so long you can hold that off. I've got some lettuce in here, I've got some kale already in here, but the lettuce you can see here is just bolting, it's just kind of shooting towards the sky, that's what bolting means, and pretty soon if I left it in, it would produce flowers and produce seed. So it's pretty much about time for this stuff to come out because I'm not going to let it go to seed right now. I need the space more than I need the seed. But I did want to show you over here, I have a lettuce plant that's been in here for a couple of months. It's already bolted and gone to seed, and you can see it's super dry, so I can actually pull this out and collect the seed from it, or probably what I'll do is just sprinkle the seed down here in this garden bed, and then it'll be ready to come up as soon as it gets cooler or whenever it decides to come up. So this is where I'm going to plant my kale. Now, I already do have some kale planted in here, and it's holding up very, very well to the heat. So that's one reason why I decided on kale, and putting it here gives it a couple hours of sunlight a day, but I can protect it from the afternoon heat. So I'm going to go ahead and pull out this lettuce and we'll get started on our kale planting. Well, I've got my lettuce all pulled out of here. I'm just going to throw it in the compost pile. But to plant my kale, it's really going to be simple. All I'm going to do is loosen up the soil a little bit because greens are like really nice loose soil. I'm going to loosen this up a little bit with my shovel. And I'm just going to add a little bit of compost. Now, I don't really need a lot because the soil has been well amended throughout the season. I've been fertilizing it. I'm adding compost tea. So it doesn't need a lot, but I did get my little pile of compost here from my compost, and I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit in just to amend the soil a little bit, get a little bit of fertilizer and food to kind of start off with. That's really all I need, really just about a quarter of an inch of compost worked into the soil. Kind of work that in. And kale is such a healthy green, and I've really been getting into eating it this summer, and I really like it best mixed in smoothies. I like it best mixed in salads with other greens, and it's great with something sweet with it, like if you put a few raisins in the salad or mixed with other greens that are a little bit sweeter, because it does have a little bit of a strong flavor. But what I found is if you pick the leaves while they're young, they're really a lot better, taste a lot better, and kale is so good for you. So I've got my kale here that I actually started indoors, and the reason why I did that rather than direct seed it is because I've had a big problem with caterpillars in my lettuce bed eating my lettuce as well. So I thought I would give it a good little start, and it's super easy for me just to throw these in the Jiffy peat pellets. I love those things because it's so convenient, it's so quick, it's so simple, it's so inexpensive, and I just have a little Tupperware container. I threw the seeds in here maybe 4 weeks ago or so, then I moved them outdoors and they've been growing in here and getting a good strong start. So hopefully the caterpillars will stay away, and I'll show you another little trick at the end to help that as well. So all I'm going to do is just dig some holes. It looks like I've got about 6 or 7 plants. So I'm going to dig, actually I'll just dig a little trench here, right here by my drip irrigation line. And I am just going to, let's see, this soil is a little bit wet. Just going to dig a little trench. And with these Jiffy peat pellets, all you need to do is just pull the netting off. You want to make sure you do that. And this is looking really good. It's got some good roots to it. Definitely needs to be planted in the ground. So pull this little netting off. And we'll make sure we got a little hole dug here. Put it in the ground, add a little bit of soil around it. And there you go. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this planted out. And then when I come back, I'm gonna show you my tip for keeping the caterpillars and the slugs away. Okay, well, I got my kale planted, and oh, Look what I found here. Okay, this is the guy that's been wreaking havoc, or at least one of the guys has been wreaking havoc on my bed. Let me bring this over here and show you guys. Okay, we got a little green caterpillar here. Now, I find his little droppings all over my lettuce. It's really disgusting, I know. But definitely not going to leave him alive. He's going to get squished. Look at him. But I want to show him to you first and then give you a little tip on how we can deal with this guy so he doesn't bother my kale. All right, so let's go on over here and let me show you what to do. Now, I actually just got this tip from, we'll leave him over here for now. I just got this tip from my gardener because previously I've been putting Sluggo Plus, which is an organic pesticide, I guess you'd call it, that you can use to help with slugs and snails and little caterpillars and that kind of thing. But the only thing about that is every time you water, you have to reapply it. So in my gardener's video recently, he said just spread sand over the soil and it'll keep them away. So I'm gonna give that a try. I got this little bucket of sand here. So I'm going to spread sand over my soil, which is also going to help my soil because I have really heavy clay soil. So eventually this will work its way in, but hopefully for now it'll keep those caterpillars and slugs and the little pill bugs and all that kind of thing away. Especially they love the newly planted seedlings. So I'm hoping this helps. It's a really simple tip and it's very inexpensive. The Sluggo Plus can be a little bit pricey. All right, so that's really about all there is to it. A late summer crop here of kale. And I just want to ask you guys, what are you doing for your late summer crops, especially the greens? The greens are really hard in the summertime because it gets so hot. So if you have any great greens that you like to plant at the end of the summer, just leave it in the comment section below and maybe we can all help each other out so we can have a really healthy green salad still at the end of the summer heat. All right, thanks a lot for watching. We'll see you next time.